Welcome back. In the TV show Prisoner, she was the one putting people behind bars. But more recently, Maggie Kirkpatrick nearly found herself locked up after a child sexual abuse conviction. Now, she appealed and the ruling was overturned. Now, for the very first time and in her only TV interview, Maggie reveals how she dealt with the allegations. Entertainment reporter Craig Bennett has this exclusive story.
Well, to our top story now, and she won acclaim for her portrayal of villains on stage and screen. But today, real-life allegations have been levelled at Aussie actress Maggie Kirkpatrick.
I couldn't believe that it was actually happening.
What about the prospect of being on the sex offenders registry?
I found it fairly scary, not knowing what the outcome was going to be. The bottom had fallen out of my world. It was like being hit with a baseball bat, really.
Maggie can never forget the day she took a phone call from the police. Take me back to the beginning of the nightmare, the allegations.
Well, that was rather extraordinary because I was heading back, you know, sort of almost this time 2 years ago, and it was actually New Year's Eve, and I was on the Pacific Highway. I think I was still probably about 700 k's from home, and my mobile rang, and it was a call from Victoria Police regarding allegations of a sexual nature that had been made against me concerning a person some 30-odd years ago. Well, on my own, on a highway, I really didn't know what the hell had hit me.
You told me with that first phone call you were nearly physically sick.
Well, yes. Yes, and more so when I gave my interview to the Victorian Police and I was appraised of the actual allegations. They were quite sick-making, really.
Was it terrifying giving evidence?
No. Why would it be terrifying? I had nothing to hide. I had the truth. There was nothing terrifying about that. The process of being in a courtroom is not something that we all do every day. I found that a little daunting. But then it certainly wasn't an American courtroom drama. It was real, and I was there in the middle of it.
So familiar with headlines for all the right reasons, now this Aussie star was finding herself on the wrong side of the news cameras.
Would you like to make a comment?
Excuse me, I need the rail.
Now, do you remember meeting your accuser those 30 years ago?
Yes, I denied nothing about my visits to her and to inviting her to my home, which is something that would never occur today, Craig. There would be no way that a publicist from a network would allow a fan to be alone with one of their stars. But those were different times, different climes, and I was used to visiting people, I was used to answering requests to visit people, sick people in hospitals, people in their homes, and this seemed to be no different.
So you had her to your place for a meal?
I don't think I want to talk about that situation or her ever again.
What was it like, though, to look at her in court, knowing that this person had turned your life around? Was it weird?
Well, weird is probably a word for it, but I was fairly numb.
But yet you bear no bitterness.
Why?
Or malice?
It's so negative. It's too I mean, my life has been shortened already by 2 years. I don't intend to shorten it any further.
How did you break the news to your daughter and to your grandkids?
With some difficulty, but at that point they were as staunch as they are today. My granddaughter said she had never seen me quite so vulnerable, and I guess I've never really been considered a very vulnerable person.
We were all left absolutely reeling when back in August a magistrate found you guilty.
Oh, well, yes, that was my daughter's reaction to that when she was phoned and told that. She said, have you got a paramedic handy? Because given my heart condition, she really thought that that would do me. But like my mother, I think I'm made of sterner stuff and got through to fight the next round.
Maggie Kirkpatrick insists that she is not guilty and will fight child sex charges.
They're pretty awful words, guilty, not guilty. Charges, offences, sexual offences, hideous, you know, good God.
What was already one of the toughest periods of Maggie's life, the relentless media onslaught made things even worse.
Was it Maggie Kirkpatrick or was it Joan Ferguson? That's what it seemed to be to me. And I have never experienced such pain and cruelty as was foisted upon me by the mass media at that time.
But how do you feel inside?
I felt sick. I felt sick and I felt betrayed and I felt that these people have the temerity to judge me. They don't know me. They didn't know the full facts. And they chose to vilify me like that. The constant images were of the most brutal moments taken out of episodes of the black leather gloves, of the body searches, of the bashing, of that look that I had. But that wasn't Maggie Kirkpatrick. So was it Maggie Kirkpatrick being accused of this crime, or was it Joan Ferguson? The lines were very blurred. Basically, it was bad journalism, wasn't it? You know, I mean, let's be real about it. It was bad reporting. Everything about it was salacious and sensational, and we don't want to go there anymore. And I think it's indicative of certain areas of our media that, well, frankly, they need to be given wide berth.
But ultimately, it was her family that got her through it all.
Never once did they doubt me. And they kept me strong too, as indeed, of course, did my daughter. They said, we'll get through it. We'll get through it. Don't you worry, Nonna, we'll get through it. I don't know what I'd do without them. I really had to latch on to that these people believe in me. So surely, surely the justice system will.
Well, I thank you for talking with me today.
It's been a pleasure, Craig.
Because I know a lot of people have had huge belief in you, love and adore you, whether they know you or whether they just respect and admire your work, and they wanted to hear your story.
Well, there it is.
And after this, no more, right?
After this, no more.
So your only television interview?
Only, the only interview, yes.
Thank you for talking to me, Maggie.
It's a pleasure, Craig.
Maggie and her story in this week's issue of New ID.